Adjusting the gain structure or gain staging your PA correctly will dramatically improve its performance, simplify operation, and even help avoid damage to loudspeaker components. In this video, we're going to show you the first part of this process, which is how to set your mixer outputs, active loudspeakers, and amplifiers for optimum performance and ease of operation. But before we get into that, what is gain structure? Gain is the change in signal level that takes place between the input and output of an electronic device. A gain stage is a point in a device where gain is applied or controlled. Gain structuring is the art of properly setting the gain of all these stages relative to each other in order to keep your mix free of noise and distortion. Mixers, amplifiers, active loudspeakers, even processors like compressors, EQs, and effects all have gain stages. There may even be multiple gain stages within a single device. A mixer, for example, will have multiple gain stages, including the microphone preamps, channel faders, and output faders. When setting gain, one of the issues you want to avoid is clipping. Clipping occurs when a signal overloads the downstream electronics in the system. It's called clipping because the tops of the waveforms are literally clipped off when a signal peak exceeds the capacity of the gain stage, which leads to distortion in the signal. You might like this from a vintage tube guitar amp, but not so much from a mixer. At the other extreme is noise. Every device has a baseline level of noise. We call this the noise floor of the device. The range between the noise floor and the point at which the device starts clipping is called the dynamic range. The difference between the signal level and the noise level is called the signal-to-noise ratio. If the level of your signal is too low, you will have a low signal-to-noise ratio and unwanted noise is added to your signal. With a high signal-to-noise ratio, the noise essentially disappears. The noise floor for any specific component is fixed. As you add pieces of gear to the system, the noise floor of each device compounds and the overall noise floor for the entire system increases. Even if every stage has an excellent signal-to-noise ratio on its own, when you chain multiple stages together, the noise of each of them is added together and the overall signal-to-noise ratio of the system will decrease, which is bad. So the more devices you have in your system and the more inputs you have coming into the mixer, the more important it is to set the gain structure correctly. We will talk more about this when we get further down the signal path. The first step in setting your system gain structure is to match the input sensitivity of your amplifier or active loudspeakers to the output level of your mixer. If you do this right, the output meters on the mixer will give you a good indication of how much of your PA you are using. So, mixer meters in the red will mean that your sound system is out of headroom and doesn't have anything else to give you. If you're using a TouchMix mixer with QSC active loudspeakers or GXD series amps, this is going to be easy. Just follow these steps. Select your output channel on the TouchMix. Go to the Setup tab. At the top of the screen, touch the button with the name of the loudspeaker or amplifier series you're going to set up. A window will open that displays the optimum settings for the selected QSC active loudspeaker or amplifier. Dial that setting into the loudspeaker or amplifier, and you're done. But maybe you aren't using QSC active loudspeakers or QSC amplifiers. Or maybe you'd just like to understand a bit more about how and why. Before we go any further, I want to clear up a common misconception. There are those who believe that the level or gain control on a power amplifier or active loudspeaker adjust power. This is not true. What these controls actually do is adjust how much voltage it takes at the input in order to drive the loudspeaker or amp to a given output level. So your 1000 watt amplifier can still produce 1000 watts no matter where that knob is set. It will just take more or less output from the mixer to get to that 1000 watts. You also need to understand what the meters and indicators on your amps and active loudspeakers are trying to tell you. Does the peak LED mean the signal is clipping, or does it mean that it's getting close to clipping? Many active loudspeakers, including QSC models, have limit lights, which indicate that the limiter circuit has been engaged. This is not the point of clipping, and this is important to be aware of. If you treat the limit light on an active loudspeaker like a clip indicator, you will be operating your system below its potential. If, on the other hand, you are running your system so that the limit LED goes on with the first note of the set and doesn't go off until the break, you need to back off a bit. All right, with that out of the way, let's go ahead and start turning some knobs. Depending on the gig and the venue, you may not have access to this stage. If you do, here's how you'll want to proceed with setting this up. You can usually start with the gain knob for your amplifier or loudspeaker at the 12 o'clock position. Play some recorded music through the mixer as a test signal. You can do this with pre-recorded tracks on the mixer or by connecting an external playback device to one of the mixer's stereo inputs. Now, bring up the mixer output fader until the peaks of the music are driving the mixer outputs well into the yellow. Listen to the level and clarity coming from the system. Check the indicators on your amps or active loudspeakers. If you're seeing clip or peak indication, back the gain control down. If you're not getting enough out of the system, slowly bring the gain control up. Your goal is to set the amplifier or active loudspeaker gain control so that the maximum undistorted output from the mixer will drive the amplifier or loudspeaker system to its full undistorted level. There may be situations where the sound system is capable of producing more output than is needed. If that's the case, you can reduce the input gain of the amplifier or loudspeaker. Repeat as needed for other mixer outputs, amplifiers, or active loudspeakers. If you are the owner of the PA, you'll probably want to set aside some time to set this up properly on your own. This can be time-consuming and potentially very loud. Making this a part of your pre-event workflow might not be the best idea. Once done, however, you can mark the gain positions or record them somewhere. This way, you'll already know exactly where to set them when you get to the gig, and you only need to worry about the mixer stage. Now that you have calibrated your amps and active loudspeakers to your mixer, you're ready to start dialing in the gain structure for all the channel inputs. We'll discuss this in part 2. See you later.